So, welcome back to my channel. This is Gamer Dom, and this is a spinning shoot and scoot driving the Tier 9 Swedish tank destroyer. Yeah, the Stuntwagon 103-0. This was his first ever game in this tank. He'd only just unlocked it, and you can see, if you look carefully, you can see me on the platoon with him. I'm in the Tortoise. Tier 9 British tank, which I'm working my way through to get to the Death Star before that gets taken away at the next patch. This was a really weird tier 10 game, sorry. If you can see, this it's a 5-10 game, and there is precisely no light tanks in either team. Three artillery and no light tanks. So Shoot decides he's gonna go and play light tank, sorry. And how about that? Can anyone explain how that happened? He got directly hit by the enemy artillery, the T-95 HMC. How is that possible? He hadn't fired a shot, he hadn't been spotted, he's got sixth sense. His camo was up. This thing is so well concealed. Chances of anything on his on the enemy team seeing him was so remote, so it must have been a blind shot or he was doing something malicious. Now, I don't think it was anything malicious, because if you notice, Shoot just stays exactly where he is. He doesn't move an inch. And if that guy had had some kind of funny thing, he probably would have put another shell in on him. But it's not the sort of start you want when you're just playing a tier 9 for the first time. And it was a fire as well, so it's going to cost him credits for the automatic fire extinguisher. So this is a real slow burner, as you would expect with no light tanks. And none of the mediums seem entirely inclined to do anything either. Enemy mediums, however, have pushed really aggressively onto the hill. And they were spotting us like crazy here. And if you notice, so I've just finally got my way up to the hill. There it is, my Tortoise crawling up the hill. And that Object 140 has no intention of helping the team at all. He's just going to sit there. And sit there. Our Batchat is just going to sit in that bush. That is it. And so this is kind of how it passes for a good little while. You can see some enemy tanks up on the hill. I think I was taking pot shots at them. But the problem is, of course, with three enemy artillery in the game, if we fire too much, you're going to get spotted, and then you're going to get the wrath of Arty on you. So Shoot's still doing his job, but it's not even his job. He's doing the job he's chosen for himself, the light tank maneuver. However, he knows that more than likely there is something at F7. And we were discussing this on TeamSpeak, and he's saying, I can't really move, I can't really fire, because if I do, I'm going to get revealed. Oh, hello. Can he get a shot on that AMX? Is it worth having a shot on the AMX? Trouble is, he's a bit nervous about giving his position away here. Understandably. Now, the Stuntwagon 103-0, in its stock state, the gun on it's actually not too bad. It's the same as the UDES has at tier 8, and that's a pretty damn good gun. It gets a lot better. Same caliber shell on the top gun on this tank, but it's not a bad stock gun at all. Now, you're going to have difficulty against some of the heavy tier 10 tanks, but against some of the others, not so much. So it's really not a hardship. Oh, hello. VK decides to come up in the middle there. Shoot tracks him. I think I did two, if I remember rightly. Is he going to get another shot? He puts a shell into the side of his turret. Now, I think, if I remember rightly, I said I've tracked him, so he fires a blind shot straight where he was, and that's it. He's dead. AMX just couldn't reload in time to put a shot into him. That clearly... Oh, where did that shell go? Wow. Okay, it's a very long range shell, but you know, it's on the right on the edge of the render range. That clue, that must show that there's nothing very much on that F7 point, because otherwise, shoot would probably have been spotted. Can some is there a window there or something? Oh, there is. Look at that. He's put it right through the window at 440 meters, something like that. Come on, hit him. Him again. Moving around too much. It's very difficult at that range. Amazing shot, though. Straight through the window at that kind of range. Can he get the kill? No, somebody else got him instead. Okay, so it's actually 3-2. And it's all a little bit tight. Let's just speed it up just a little bit. Because really, very little happens. Except a couple of our tanks die. Oh, hello. There's the Sturmfagen. So there's the Tier 10 Swedish tank destroyer. He was hiding on that F7 spot. It's back to 3-all. You can see our team has gone so defensive, and it's difficult to be harsh on that because at the end of the day, we've got no neither team's got any light tanks. The only thing I was disappointed in this game was that 104, sorry, 140, Object 140, just spent the whole sort of first 5 minutes of the game sitting there in front of me. That should be a hit. Doing nothing, and then when we kind of needed him to spot, he rushed over to the A3 area, and it's kind of like you're not really doing an awful lot to help the team here. Anyway, what can you do? There's no I in team. Yeah. Oh, blimey, that blind shot again from shoot must have destroyed his tracks on that 113 because he just got assistance damage there. He wasn't expecting that. Okay, so Willow. E75. Put one shell into him. You can see the enemy have finally come forward, pushed hard. That E75 cannot see shoot at all. He's moved as you saw that bush go down. T-54. Oh, nice shot. He hadn't moved. That must have been something else. So he was sitting there pummeling him from distance. You can see on the mini-map there's a T-54 threatening my position. I think that was me. I put one into him, but shoot really hasn't got a shot. And even if, and there goes me. I got taken down by my opposite number, who's up on the hill. I was being peppered continually there. It was really hard. When you're in a big slow-moving slug like a tortoise, it's very, very difficult to get into any position, especially when your team haven't pushed forward at all. And I got myself a little bit caught in no man's land. I probably would have been better of camp base, but hey, it's not my style. I don't like doing that. I camp quite happily, but not base. So anyway, I'm down. Shoot's still doing his scouty job. He's done 1500 damage that we know of. There's a couple of well, blind shots. Oh, and he tracks the 54 there. Gets spotted for his troubles. He's got to move because he'll be shot by arty. T-54 goes down. Good job. Right, so shoot's got to get moving. He came out of the siege mode and he's going to wiggle around, try and put off the arty off their scent. It was a weird game because he got hit initially by that arty, but after that, neither of us saw any arty shells at all. Now, there were other threats from our team, so I guess that's where the arty were focusing, but it just seemed very odd. Get nothing at all with three artillery. So, again, real nip and tuck stuff, this very, very tight match. One of the reasons why I chose this game to show you, because it was so, plus, shoot, badgered me. But it was so tight, and that's kind of. Well, nice. Lovely aim time on this gun. Is he pulled right back, do you reckon? Shoot thinks so, puts a blind shot into where he reckoned that object had gone to. And it's 8 plays 6. Now, the problem is, because that object 140 isn't really pushing forward, our Malshan is on very low health, our T-30 is on very low health, and they're sort of stuck, basically, around the enemy base. But there is a 103B up on that hill, up on the... oh, hello. Can shoot get a shot into him? Yes, he can. Oh! Whoa! That was a bit unfortunate. Looks like it hit him perfectly in the hull. But actually, he must have hit him with a turret. That was a anticipation shot. Now, as I was saying, the problem here, we've got this the 103B, which is presumably still on F7 area. And really, we need to light him up. But his camo is going to be so good, it's very, very difficult to do that. The shooter's now on half health, which does not help. And you can see that we're trying to get that 140 to move, just if nothing else to do some spotting. He's our only medium left. He just really didn't want to do anything to help the team. Let's go forward, double it up, double speed. If you notice, there's a T-95 has got up onto the hill as well. Plus, the tortoise is now down, so... Oh, looks like that T-54 is running, which is good. That's a good indication that they've pulled back, the enemy team. Malshan is still stuck, he can't move. T-30's likewise stuck, can't move. Because of the covering fire, so... Shoot gets a signal from the RT saying they're aiming at that point on the hill, on the F7 area. He's still understandably a little bit nervous about moving forward. There are still two enemy artillery in the game, plus a couple of very powerful TDs. Come on, Shoot. Move forward. You know you want to. So he wasn't sure what to do here. You know, it's a difficult situation. He's only on half health. We're winning the game quite convincingly in terms of damage left. But there, as Shoot said there, there's only 2 minutes left. And there is the Stumpfwagen. Look, he only had to go a little bit further forward and he spotted it. Got spotted for his troubles. Guess that was fairly inevitable. T-95 up there on the hill. Shoot can't pen him direct. I think he's got his eyes on our tanks coming off the hill. So Shoot's going to put some speed down. Pedal to the metal. Try and get into a position where he can support. There goes our Malshan. Got taken out by the T-54. No shot there. Oh, there's a 704 down there. Nice. Finishes off with a kill. Only one thing left now, and that is the RT. And he's played it very, very cannily here. Shoot, he played the role of the scout because there was nobody else. And he did a pretty darn good job. Arty gets cleaned up before he can get the shot at it. But GG, well played. So he got his first class for that, which is not bad in your first ever game in the tank. He got spotter, bruiser, fire for effect. Finished top of the team, nearly 4,000 damage, 25 short of 4,000 damage, 3 kills, 1,098 base XP. Even though I died quite early, I still got 1,200 damage. I didn't get any kills, but 749 base XP. So Shoot fired 21 guns. Hit with 15 and penned with 12 for that 2,000 damage. He took one hit himself, which was that arty shot, which was just wicked at the very beginning there. Did a huge amount of damage to him. But he did get 3,303 assistance damage. That's really what helped his score get into the first class area. And not bad cash generation. 62,000, best part of. Shells are expensive. Didn't use any premium, I don't think. So just shy of 29,000 profit. So there you go.